Ever since the internet was created, it's been organized around basic principles of openness, fairness, and freedom. The idea of net neutrality has unleashed the power of the internet and given innovators the chance to thrive. Abandoning these principles would threaten to end the internet as we know it.
The internet as it has always existed is a platform of free and equal access. Anyone with access to the internet can produce, regardless of his or her economic background. The frontrunners of the cable industry would like to change this. Companies like Verizon, Comcast, and Time Warner Cable have proposed to allocate bandwidth distribution based upon paid prioritization. This would create a two-tier system with fast lanes and slow lanes, where companies with higher financial capabilities would be able to operate at faster speeds than those without. Basically, the cable industry would like to require companies with higher bandwidth needs to pay larger sums of money for proper functioning.
Hello, Internet. Enjoying your interneting session, perhaps watching this video with lots of tabs open in the background, full of interesting things to check out?
I'm mostly on Facebook, Twitter, Tumblr.
I like Instagram a lot. Uh-huh. I like Facebook because it's just turned into a great way to stay in touch with family.
I'm on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, and Snapchat. Those are the big four for me.
Well, a lot of it is videos actually now. And there are video platforms existing in social media, Vine and others upcoming. Snapchat is really popular. I like that too. So it's mostly pictures or videos or pictures which are animated GIFs. So that's mostly the content I see.
Disgusting content. I hate the Facebook news feed. I think it's the worst of all the feeds that I'm exposed to.
Generally, it tends to be like fluff, like info, like little upworthy articles with like random statistics from who knows where. And not obviously like people don't tend to like share hard-hitting news articles on Facebook. I guess it's just not the format for it.
There's a lot of, you know, upworthy, these weird inspirational things. I'll see like weird memes being shared. I'll see on Facebook so many articles from weird websites that like aren't reputable sources, like websites I've never heard of before that just make these like weird viral links.
People of our generation arguably use the internet more than any other age group. We Instagram, post videos on our newsfeed, read countless articles a day, and stay up to date on the latest news through Twitter. Ironically, not a whole lot of what we share tends to focus on the issues of this very platform. So, why don't our peers talk more frequently about an issue so relevant to their lives?
I've heard of the phrase, but exactly don't know what it means.
I am not aware of that now.
Yeah, I've heard of net neutrality.
To quote the bill up for the February 26th ruling, not later than 90 days after the date of the enactment of this act, the Commission shall promulgate regulations that, 1, prohibit a broadband provider from entering into an agreement with an edge provider under which the broadband provider agrees for consideration in transmitting network traffic over the broadband internet access service of an end user, and so on.
And that's the problem. The cable companies have figured out the great truth of America. If you want to do something evil, put it inside something boring.
So, you know, I'm not an expert on net neutrality, but I think net neutrality is kind of the idea of having a free internet, free web, kind of, it's not restricted. I'm not sure if it's related to this idea of certain companies being able to pay for higher speed, so, you know, a company with a lot of money could make it so their website is faster, therefore kind of underground websites would go slower. Is that part of it? I don't know. Is that a different thing?
What's going on?
On February 26th, the FCC will hold a vote on whether to reclassify the internet under Title II of the Telecommunications Act. Title II would maintain net neutrality and keep the internet open and free. We want the FCC to make this ruling a reality, as it would prevent cable companies from prioritizing bandwidth.
I mean, I hate cable companies. I used to work for one. And basically, it's pretty unethical in terms of how they charge higher fees. And I've seen that going down in distribution deals with networks.
Of course, I want an open, free internet. I don't support companies trying to restrict it. I want freedom of voice and freedom of information for everyone.
The FCC is an independent agency, and ultimately this decision is theirs alone.
We need you to get out there and for once in your lives, focus your indiscriminate rage in a useful direction. Seize your moment, my lovely trolls. Turn on caps lock and fly, my pretties.
So how can we help? Well, if you care about the internet, use it to save it.
Stay up to date on legislation regarding the internet.
Make your voice heard through all of your social media platforms and make sure to inform others of the upcoming FCC vote.
Take a stand against the FCC. Advocate for net neutrality preservation on the website. The internet is currently a free platform. Let's keep it that way.
As a generation that values the internet, it is our duty to defend net neutrality.